Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. Today is day 5 of my 5 days with Kaleido, so it's also the last day. And today we are going to play with this one. This is the Futurism 5, I've told it like this. The Futurism 5, and it's the electro turquoise, and this is the look I created with this one. I tried to keep it wearable, but I don't know if I really succeeded. But yeah, the color story is really bright, as you can see. It's like a very cute teals, turquoises and oranges, and yeah, I love this color story. I must say I bought both this palette and the VR Neon palette because I was so drawn to this one and I just wanted to complete the set. I think that I was seriously thinking maybe just getting only this one, but you know, shipping, taxes, everything, I thought it would be just easier to get everything. I really, really adore these color stories. I'm really drawn into the teal and orange combination. I also think that the pastel palette from Huda Beauty, the green one, the minty one, is so cute because it combines these orangey and peachy shades with the teal. So I think that is a really cute color story. I am going to swatch this palette. And I hope I'm going to say the shade names right. I only messed up with editing. I saw that I only messed up a few times with the VR Neon, and I'm really proud of that. So I am going to go, I think, I'm going to go from this side to this side because then the darkest ones are the last ones. And I have to really think because I'm not doing it in the same order I am used to. So yeah. Okay, this is Shockwave. It's like, I think it's kind of a topper shade. Maybe I should, I think it's kind of a topper shade. It has I would say a transparent base, and then it's like, it has some gold and silver shifts. Really, really stunning as a topper shade, I must say. Then this one is Force Field. And this is such a stunning shade. I really love it. It's a bit crumbly. But I think that is because they are so buttery in the pan that they come off a little crumbly on the in the swatch. And this is Voltaic, I think I'm saying that right. I don't know, Voltaic. And this one is also really hard to show you how bright it is because somehow my camera doesn't pick it up. In my viewfinder, it looks like a moss green while it is like a neon orange. Okay, then the next shade is Tron. That's also a shimmer. That's this one. This is so beautiful. This is so beautiful. It's so smooth. Working with this one, I noticed I had to use my like setting spray or an adhesive or your finger because it didn't really want to pack on the same as the other shimmer shades I used before from the other palettes. But the reason for that is because I think I had already used 2 mattes on my eyes. So yeah, it wasn't like sticky, it was very soft, and you know, I had to put it over a matte shadow. Okay, I'm explaining this really nicely. Then Digiteal, that's this one. I'm going to build that up because this is Digiteal. And then the last one, that's the dark brown one, that's Wired. I'm really so bad at swatching. All right, these are all the colors, and I have to my hand like this. So you have Shockwave over here, then this is Force Field, Voltaic, Tron, Digiteal, and Wired. So yeah, this is the color story I'm going to work with today. I created this look using this color story, and I really enjoyed working with this because, as I said, I really, really like these shades. And it was a bit of a challenge keeping it wearable. I have seen a lot of like inspirational pictures before I bought this, and this is something I think a lot of people just naturally go for, a look like this. So I will link down the Kaleido's Instagram down in the description box so you can see some more pictures if you want some inspiration how to use this palette other than this video. Okay guys, I hope you enjoy the look, and we are jumping into it right now. Okay, I'm going to start off with my MAC 217S, that's this one. I'm going to go into this one, that's Force Field, and I'm going to start on my outer corner and put it in the crease a little bit. Ooh. This is the first time I'm using this palette. I'm going to stamp it on where I want most color, and then I'm going to blend it out, and I'm going to drag it halfway through my crease because I want to do a duo colored crease with the orange. I'm going to let the orange meet the turquoise. Okay, can I just say I'm kind of done. You just stamp it on and you're done. That's hilarious. I'm just stamping it on and I think I'm done. I'm going to blend it out a teensy bit higher up, but I'm done. And I'm going to clean up the sides, but I'm done with this color. All right, I have done Force Field, so I am going to go into Voltaic. That's the orange one. This one also, again, mustardy colored, but very, very bright in the pan, so I don't know why. And this is my Sigma E27. I've used this with, I don't know, the second palette, I think, already. So if you want to know the difference between this one and the E20 or something, just watch that video. Okay, I'm going to start a little bit lower because I don't want to have it very high up in my crease. Same thing as the turquoise. I'm just going to, where that Force Field shade, I'm going to just stamp it on, and it has a lot of punch. So you seriously don't have to, you don't have to use a lot of time getting these colors on your eyes, and that is like amazeballs. I don't use a sticky base. I've just set my eyelids with, or I just prep my eyelids with MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot, and then I set it with a eyeshadow. And to be honest, it's just because I think it makes it a little bit easier. I don't set my whole eye, I just set this part. And I think it's just a little bit easier to blend, but you really don't have to with this. I think you can even make it more pronounced if you don't. I think I'm going to leave it like this because you see the color peeping up enough and peeping out enough, and it's not going to be too bold. So I'm just going to leave it here. Okay, I've blended it a little bit into that shock field. No, force field, shockwave force field. I've taken that Voltaic color and I've blended it a little bit into that turquoise force field color, but not too much because I think it's going to get muddy. So I just very lightly stamped the color into that line. So it is blended, but it's not too, yeah, no, too extreme. Well, this is going very well, very quick. I think I'm going into that dark teal, that is Digiteal, that's this one. And I'm going to use that on my outer corner. And I think I'm also going to use a E27 brush for that because I think it's just an easy brush to use. Don't want to use the orange one because I don't want to, I want to be able to blend later on. So I'm going to just use this. I'm sorry, I'm just, this one. I'm going to try and keep it really in that outer V, but I think it's okay to drag it a bit further down my lid because there's going to be some shimmer over it anyway, and I think it's nice to have a darker outer corner. I'm also going to use that brown shade, that wire shade in my outer corner, but I think I can really deepen up that teal because it's not that extreme, as you can see. And I do want to keep this wearable, even though I think with a color scheme like this, it's not very easy. But in the end, I think all the palettes can be used to make them wearable. You can combine colors from all five to create something that is less out there. What I'm noticing with this color is that you can blend it out very easily, but it also loses its punch. If you want to have a big color payoff, I suggest stamping. And I think keeping your base a little tacky is not a bad idea because it does blend away a little bit. Yeah, it does. It is getting messy here. All right, then we're going into the shimmers. I'm going to use, of course, my Smith 253 Arrowhead brush. And I'm going into that teal shimmer that is named Tron. And I'm wiggling it. It's like it looks a little crumbly. Okay, what am I going to do? I think I'm going to just start a little bit on the outer edge. It's not... Yeah, this is the first time I feel I have to spray my brush because it's laying on two layers of dry matte eyeshadows and it's not really gripping. So I'm going to spray my brush, but I am going to keep this color a bit on the outer corner side because it's very blue. You can use water to spray your brush. You don't have to use setting spray. Please don't let anyone fool you into thinking you need setting spray. You don't. I think it's sometimes it's even better because people can be allergic to the setting spray and they get all sorts of weird reactions on their eyes. Don't use it if you don't need it. I'm using a very cheap one, the Catrice Prime Fine. It has a matte finish and I don't use matte setting sprays, so. Okay, I'm dragging it halfway until that point where the teal meets the orange. And I am going to see what this shockwave color is doing. They were strong, yeah. I'm going to use this one next. I'm going to use the same brush. I'm just going to clean it off on my color switch. And that dries it up. Yeah, it's dry now. It's dry again. So I'm going into Shockwave, wiggling, same as I did. It looks a little. It looks like it has a bit of a golden duochrome. I'm going to start at the very edge. Oh. The thing is, these are not very foiled. They're really, really crumbly. So I think I need to use my sprayer again. But the problem with that, I think, is it's going to make it look very foiled, and that is not something I really like on my eyes. Yeah. Okay, well, we're going to see. It is a bit golden. I think I'm going to, ooh, it's nice like this. I just don't like the fact because it's so foiled right now. I think that's such a shame that you have to spray your brush. I don't really enjoy that. But it makes a cut crease just like that, you see? I just have a cut crease. I didn't do anything for it. I just have a cut crease. Okay, I'm going to do the other side as well. Okay, I have both of the shimmer shades Tron and Shockwave on my eyes right now. And it's very, very glimmery and very glittery. I think it's difficult to make this really wearable because if you don't foil it, it's not going to be showing up. And if you foil it, or foil, like, spray your brush, you make it, you know, more pronounced. It's too pronounced. And I've... Ooh, that wasn't smart. I have fallout. I hope you can see that. I'm going to turn down my lights a little. If you can see, I have a lot of shimmers on my cheek right now because I had some fallout and I wiped it away instead of just cleaning it up with a brush or something. Well, that is why I always do my base last. Okay. Well, I'm going to darken up the outer corner with some of that brown color, and that is called Wired. And I'm going to use that River Brush number 14. I really like because it's very pointy and slanted. This is the color Wired, and I'm going to use that to deepen up that outer corner a little. Ooh, that's very pigmented. Okay, well, I'm keeping it very much concentrated on that outer corner because I don't want this to be too overwhelming. Going to try and blend it out. So I clean my brush a bit because I don't want it to add more color. I just want to blend it a little bit more. Okay, using that E27 brush from Sigma, I'm going back in Digiteal and I'm going to cover that brown up a little because I don't really like the effect it gave. But what it's doing right now, it's making that Digiteal color really dark, and that is something that is, I think, more fitting to this look than that stark brown color. So I'm doing that on the other side as well. Yeah, what I'm going to do, I'm going to go with that, what's it called? That Tron color. And I'm going to gently blend that into that outer corner a bit. Yeah, that's better. Makes it a little bit more finished and blended and intended. And yeah, okay, just to assess a little bit, what I see happening is that force field and voltaic shape blend out into, well, I don't want to say nothingness, but for me, this is now a very, for me, it is okay that it's blending out, like it's disappearing a little bit, and I don't mind that because I don't want a very bold crease. But I can imagine that if you want that crease to be bold and showing, and you've built it up and then you blend it, it can disappear a bit. So a sticky base, if you want like this really artsy Instagram baddie type of look, then I think you really need to use a sticky base and keep it sticky, because as you can see, it's getting a little patchy here. You just blend it away, and it's also the foils of my lid that's doing that, but you are blending it away, as you can see. But I think for now, for this look, it's fine, it's okay as it is. All right, well, now I've used all the shades in the palette, so I'm going to finish up the rest of my face, putting up some mascara. I'm not going to put up a liner because I think that is going to be too much. So I'm going to be back with a full face. I have done the rest of my face. I put on some mascara, did my brows, put a little bit of lip gloss on, nothing fancy. And I am going to finish up. What I also did, I corrected this outside corners a little bit too much. I dragged it down a teensy bit. If I think it's too low at the end, I'm just going to use some concealer and make it a little less. But I think we can connect my lower lash line very nicely to that turquoise color. So that is what we are going to do. I am going to go into that force field shade, and I'm going to use E36, but this is just a clean one, and I'm going into that force field shade, this light turquoise one, and I am going to put this on my lower lash line. I'm going to step it off a little. And I'm going to connect it to this part and then drag it along the lower lash line. And I'm going to stop halfway so I can put the orange in the front, just mimicking the top of my eye, like so. I think it's nice that I dragged it down a little bit more than I did, or than I corrected, because now it's like a nice shape. All right, then I'm going to just clean this one up, because I don't really mind if there's a little bit of the teal color. I'm going to go into that Voltaic. That's like a very bright orange, but shows up, I don't know why, mustardy on my camera. And I'm going to connect this to the teal and dragging it to my inner corner, like so. And I think that's fun because it mimics the top half of my eye a bit. And I'm not going to, like I said before, I'm not someone who likes a very elaborate lower lash line. I just like it to clean it up a little, tie the look together a bit. I'm also going to use this ditchy teal color to connect the outer corners. I'm going to just keep this at the outer part of my lower lash line. It was a bit difficult for me to do this and show you at the same time. So as you can see, I'm just making a V, tying it all together. I think that looks cute. All right. Okay, I'm going to get my sponge. There's a little bit of concealer still on here, and I'm just using this sponge like so to make that edge a little less harsh. Doing the same on the other side. Okay, I think I'm going to leave it like this. I'm going to put something in my inner corner, like the same thing I did on my brow bone, and I'm going to put some mascara down, and then I will be back with the conclusion. This is the finished look, and I am quite happy with it. I don't know per se if it's going to be like wearable, but if I have to use every shade, then it's not that easy to make it very wearable. If you would just, you know, use like the lighter shades and not the bright ones, then you could make something very wearable out of this. Just keep it small, keep it soft, you know, just having this, I'm just totally don't know. I'm not going to say the shade name because it's annoying. I think if you use this orange with a bit of this and maybe a little bit of this in the on your lower lash line, then it could be very cute and very nice. So yeah, that is something. Well, I must say that I really enjoyed this color story. I think it's really fun. The shades perform really nicely, but as I said, the matte ones, that Force Field and Voltaic, these two shades, Voltaic and Force Field, I think you really need to use a sticky base, stamp the color on, and if you blend it out, just do it with a very soft brush and not too rigorously, because it can blow away and be a bit patchy. So you can blend it away, that is what I wanted to say, and it can be a bit patchy. So that is something I found. Also the two shimmers, that Shockwave and Tron Shockwave, they are not as creamy, but they're like these special shades. They're very pretty, you know, but it's like you have to make them pop by using some adhesive or spraying your brush, maybe use your finger. I didn't think they were as easy as the shades or the shimmer shades I was using in the first three palettes. That was just, they were the most easy. Also in the Astro Pink ones, no, the VR Neon ones I used yesterday, I think the shimmer shades were a little bit easier to pick up and lay down. These feel like more of a topper shade, especially this one. I think it's just the formula. It's a special shade. They have created it probably to suit that purpose. All right, that was it for my 5 days of Kaleidos. Thank you so much for watching. I think I will be doing a palette bingo with these five, because I really want to see how you can combine the colors. I think you can combine the colors in the palettes to make it like, I will never depot them, because this packaging is like otherworldly, so I will never depot them. But I think that having them all together, you can create looks with all five, switching up the shades in the palette. So I think I'm going to do a palette bingo one day. I think that would be really fun. There are like five shades in each palette, and I have five palettes, so that would be fun. Okay guys, I think I'm going to sign off. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you think this is considered wearable. I think it's a bit too much, but I really like it because I really love the colors. But yeah, give this video a thumbs up if you liked what you saw, and please subscribe if you haven't already, and I hope I will see you in my next one. Bye.